ReReviews! Portal. Pre-review. Funny story, I actually played Portal 2 before I ever played the original Portal. So I was actually kind of going back and doing a re-review at the very start when I first played this game. But I really liked Portal 2. I thought that the characters were really well written, that it had this beautiful, almost gallows sensibility for humor, and that it was very unique, this idea that I was kind of new to, of physics-based puzzle games. Playing the original Portal did feel like, you know, I already kind of knew the story going in, but when I finally got a chance to play it, I was a little bit familiar with it. I was a little bit concerned because I figured that there might not be as much meat on the bones as the second game. On pre-review, I was on board. I'd give it a 7 out of 10. I was definitely in a good place going in. Review! Yeah, Portal's good, man. Portal's a really interesting, innovative puzzle game. And the great thing about it is that it really does understand how to do puzzles and how to ramp up difficulty. And it does that with a really great learning curve. The basic mechanics, for those who are not aware, and I can't imagine there are many people who aren't, is that you have a portal gun, and you can shoot a blue portal, and you can shoot an orange portal, and you can have one of each at any time. And you can go into one and come out the other one. So you can traverse a landscape in these new and interesting ways by using these portals. But anything can actually go through those portals, as you start to realize. You know, you can put cubes through the portals. But if there's a turret on the other side, the turret can also shoot through those portals. The way the game is set up, though, is that it introduces a basic idea. They actually start you with just the one portal. And so you understand how this works in relation to the other portal that's getting shot at intervals, and how you can interact with the world. And eventually they give you control over both, and then you see all of the different ways that this can be implemented over the course of the testing. This is really well done, because new elements are implemented all the time that keep changing up the basic ideas, but at the same time, you are never really lost as to how to utilize the mechanics that are in front of you. At the same time, it's actually pretty basic. The only real things that you do are blast two different kinds of portals. They never go beyond that. You have the blue portal, you have the orange portal, and you can also, like, move blocks. You can pick up blocks and you can move them. That's it. That's, like, all you're really able to do. And you would think that that's very limiting, but actually what it means is that it keeps everything streamlined. You don't get into needlessly complex scenarios at any given time. So it means that when you come up against a new challenge, you realize that you have a few basic things you can do in order to get from point A to point B. And that's basically what you want to do in every single one of these test chambers. So the story, if you don't know, you play Shell. Shell is one of the test subjects at Aperture Science, and there is this disembodied voice, who we know as GLaDOS, the insane AI, that insists on running these test subjects through a bunch of test chambers, sort of to see if they are able to solve these puzzles, and in many ways to test the latest technology from Aperture, which in this case is the portal gun. This is a game that's full of things that became memes, not just with GLaDOS, not just from the theme song Still Alive, but also, of course, that the cake is a lie, which you'll learn a lot more about when you actually play. Basically, there is a point where things go wrong, and you've completed all of the tests that are in front of you, and they've decided that it's time to basically dispose of you, and they want to throw you into an incinerator. And it's at this point that they do this interesting juxtaposition where you have to figure out how you get out of that scenario, and you now use your new portal gun to actually go outside of the testing. And then you're sort of in the skunk works behind the scenes of Aperture, and that's how you eventually resolve and get to GLaDOS and eventually take her on. The game is incredibly streamlined. Of course, that also means that it's actually pretty short. In fact, you can complete the entire thing in 2 hours. And, you know, if you're a really speed-runny player, you can probably do it in one. But you may be tempted to kind of go into these little Easter egg areas, these hidden areas where you can obviously see some of the test subjects that got behind the official testing area and have left notes and have left, like, warnings to the next people that are running through it. That was really neat. And you do want to kind of stop, take a moment, and appreciate that level of detail that they put into the game. While Portal is not particularly long, the great thing about it is that you can definitely feel the passion that people had for this game. This game was made by a group of modders that, like, saw Half-Life and were like, oh, we could use the engine to actually make this really unique thing. And they did, and in some ways, this basically revolutionizes, it's the start of physics-based puzzle games. And that is a huge accomplishment, and I really did enjoy playing it. Obviously, it was not a very long experience for me, but it was a very enjoyable one. And in some ways, I prefer to have a short and sweet adventure rather than a long, tedious grind fest. Because, you know, I feel completely satisfied and I get it over and done in a couple hours. Personality and everything, my expectations were definitely met. And just because I was like, you know, this is a game that started, that led to Portal 2, which I was already familiar with at that time, I was like, yeah, I can absolutely give it an 8 out of 10. Re-review. Going back to Portal, I played Still Alive, and that basically gives you the game, but also gives you a bunch of these other individual challenges. Some of them are more challenging versions of the rooms that you already encountered in the main game. Some of them are like the Still Alive challenges, which are completely new rooms. And there's also like time trials for different sections of the game. And as you can imagine, this ends up extending the length of the game quite considerably. I would say that it probably doubles the overall length. I actually didn't play much of it because after that 2-hour experience of just going through that storyline and seeing the conclusion of it, I was good. And I was like, okay, I'll play around with some of this extra content. But even though I was talking about how the game is kind of short and everything, I really didn't feel like I wanted to extend it any more than that. That's good. I like that. I think I'm done now. While Portal doesn't necessarily have a lot of replayability, you don't feel bad going back and just replaying the game. Even if it's the same basic experience that you had before, you don't feel bad going back and playing it again and remembering that this was a really excellent, well-crafted, short and sweet, mind you, game. This is also the game that just launched the entire physics-based puzzle game genre. So when you get to, like, Turing Test and Cube and all of those, you start to realize that, you know, there's an originator here, and the originator in this particular case is Portal. But something that I was trying to put out of my mind, going into being able to say that I could review it objectively, was what Portal 2 was like. Portal 2 is significantly bigger. It's longer, the story is richer, the characters are richer, they're more fleshed out. They do so much more with that formula, and they implement some really cool new ideas, the fluid physics and everything. Some really difficult challenges, too. I am very proud to say that I was able to make it through Portal and Portal 2 without using any walkthroughs or anything. I figured it out. Of course, sometimes you're confronted with like a giant chamber that goes straight up that has just a dead drop into nothingness, and you have to figure out how you're going to use all of these mechanics to work your way up to the very top. You know, you feel very satisfied when you complete puzzles. Portal 2 had a lot more story. It fleshed all of this out, and it does really make Portal, the original, feel like, I guess I'd say like a framework. Sort of like when I was talking about Assassin's Creed, how the original game really did feel like a framework for games that would come after it. It starts to make the original feel that way. Nevertheless, of course, the original Portal is a classic, and it's enjoyable. It is still short, even with all of the extra things that they put onto it by modern standards, which is how we're looking at it right now, it is particularly short. And I would say that I don't want to discount it any kind of points, for the fact that it's still as good as it was before. It really has aged very nicely, and it still feels pretty fresh, especially if you're not familiar with physics puzzlers. But also, knowing everything that came after it, I don't really know if I can step it up at all, because I would definitely say for people who are new to this, you'd really want to play Portal, but only with the caveat that you play Portal 2 directly after that, and try some of the other great physics puzzlers. Like I did mention Turing Test and Cube. Turing Test doesn't have as much in terms of physics puzzles, but it's still the same basic concept, and I enjoyed those as well. It's good if you're looking for a firm reference point to what all the other, like, physics puzzles in first-person perspective were past that. So on re-review, I'm still giving it an 8 out of 10. I can't deduct it any points. It's not like it's worse today than it was before. It's still good. It's still as good as when I played it. I'll give you a little re-recap so you can see those scores. But in general, yeah, Portal, if you didn't get a chance to play it before, I would totally suggest trying to find it, play it. If you did play it before, I can tell you that coming back to it did feel very nice, put a smile on my face, and reminded me about this, you know, really classic game. It was incredibly creative, it was incredibly innovative, it had beautiful personality, and that eventually leads them to do Portal 2, which, again, that was a really, really excellent game. At least in my mind, it was an excellent game. I don't know, when I go back and play it again, I don't know if I would feel the same way. I guess that's why I do these. So I see if I still feel the way I felt. In the case of the original Portal, though, my initial impressions and my current impressions match up. So there's something. All right, everyone. Thank you for joining us on ReReviews. And as always, don't forget to dislike and unsubscribe. There is no cake. There, I said it. That deserves a dislike right there. The fact that I came out and dashed your cake dreams. You think we'll ever get a Portal 3? I don't think so. I think Valve has pretty much checked out of the Portal and Half-Life game. I don't know why, like they wouldn't sell a billion copies. There's one thing about Portal 3 that I kind of want to see, and at the same time I don't know if I want, which is the idea of being able to throw out 4 portals instead of 2. Because a part of me is like, well, it's easy enough to do, especially on modern controllers, because you usually have 2 triggers, and you have 2 secondary buttons, like the bumpers. You know, depending on what you're looking at, you usually have 1 set and then a secondary set. So there you go, you can throw out 4 different portals, because that's your main mechanic, and you can do that all on your trigger fingers. So you could have like a red and a green, maybe, and then you have the blue and the orange. The problem with that, of course, is which portal leads you into which next portal, and which portal is connected to which other portal. Like, could two portals be connected here, and could 2 portals just be connected here? Or are they all connected together? I don't know why I did that. And then the other part of me is like, maybe don't do that, because I think it's gonna get so confusing really fast. And I think it's almost too many mechanics. In the interest of simplicity, maybe avoid that. If they did it, I'd be there for it and I'd try it. I might not be able to do it, but I'd be interested in it. Hey, there you go, Val. Maybe there's a reason to get on that Portal 3. 4 portals at the same time. Yeah, that's gonna make you want to do something. Heard it here first, folks. Oh, new idea. A Portal Rick and Morty crossover event.
Okay, the turret can't see me, but I can see you. Wait a second. Here we go. Ooh, look at this. Now I'm in here. No, I'm not going to put
you
down.
Android. Aww. The Enrichment Center once again reminds you that Android Hell is a real
That's
place
an achievement.
Where you will be sent at the first sign of defiance.
I didn't know that, but I'm happy.